Hello friends, in this video I am going to solve a problem on the second law of thermodynamics. In this problem, there is a reversible heat engine that is operating between two thermal reservoirs which are at 800 degrees Celsius and 30 degrees Celsius respectively. It drives a reversible refrigerator operating between minus 15 degrees Celsius and 30 degrees Celsius. The heat input to the heat engine is 1900 kilojoules, and the net work output from the combined plant, that is engine and refrigerator both, is 290 kilojoules. Calculate the heat absorbed by the refrigerant and the total heat transferred to 30 degrees Celsius reservoir. See, in all the second law of thermodynamics problems, we should always write its block diagram. So if the block diagram is written, then the 50% problem is solved. So first let us start with a reversible heat engine. There is a reversible heat engine. This is heat engine. This is operating between two thermal reservoirs. One is at 800 degrees Celsius. T1 is 800 degrees Celsius. That is, it is a high temperature thermal reservoir. And another reservoir, which is at 30 degrees Celsius. That is a small T2. Is 30 degrees Celsius. As usual, heat engine receives Q1 amount of heat from the high temperature thermal reservoir or source, and that value here it is given that heat input to the heat engine is 1900 kilojoules. It is 1900 kilojoules. This will produce work output. Let us take it as W from engine, and it rejects Q2 amount of heat to a low temperature thermal reservoir or sink. Then we have a refrigerator, right? We have a refrigerator. This refrigerator is operating between two thermal reservoirs. One is at 30 degrees Celsius, same as this one, and the other one, sorry, not in this direction, this is here, the direction is opposite, and the other one is a low temperature thermal reservoir. Let us take this one as T2 dash. This is minus 15 degrees Celsius. Is given here, it is minus 15 degrees Celsius, and high temperature thermal reservoir is as usual 30 degrees Celsius. See, this T2 will be T1 dash for this refrigerator, that is 30 degrees Celsius. This refrigerator receives Q2 dash of heat from low temperature thermal reservoir, and it will send Q1 dash amount of heat to high temperature thermal reservoir by consuming W refrigeration of work, and this combined heat engine refrigerator plant is producing a net work output of, see here, it is 290 kilojoules. It is producing 290 kilojoules, that is W net is equal to 290 kilojoules. Here in this problem, we should find out the heat absorbed by the refrigerant. Here heat absorbed by the refrigerant is this one, that is Q2 dash. As per the principle of refrigeration, the heat that is received in the refrigerator is the heat absorbed by the refrigerant. So that is happening at the thermal reservoir, which is at minus 15 degrees Celsius, and that heat received is Q2 dash here. If we find out Q2 dash, that first one, will be resolved, and we should find out the total heat transferred to 30 degrees Celsius. So to this 30 degrees Celsius reservoir, see, this is 30 degrees Celsius reservoir. Here there will be heat transfer of Q2 to this one and also Q1 dash to this one. So total heat transfer to 30 degrees Celsius is Q2 plus Q1 dash. So what is this that is to be calculated? So let us solve one by one. Let us solve this WHE, this Q2, W refrigerator, Q1 dash, Q2 dash. All the values have to be calculated. So let us start with efficiency of heat engine to solve this WHE. So efficiency of reversible heat engine is given by this is equal to 1 minus T2 divided by T1. Here T2, this small T2 is 30 degrees Celsius, then the capital T2 will be in the Kelvin. Here always we should use the temperature in the Kelvin scale. So this 30 plus 273 will be 303 Kelvin, and similarly capital T1 will be 800 plus 273. This will be 1073 Kelvin, and this T2 will be T1 dash also. That T1 dash is also 303 Kelvin. It is 303 Kelvin. Similarly, here T2 dash will be this is 258 degree Kelvin. So now let us find out efficiency of this heat engine. So this will be 1 minus T2 is 303 divided by 1073 Kelvin. So the efficiency of this heat engine is 0.7176, or it is 71.76%. See, the efficiency of heat engine is also given by W heat engine divided by heat input. So here efficiency of heat engine is 0.7176, that is equal to WHE, that is unknown, that is to be calculated, divided by Q1 is this 1900 kilojoules. It is 1900 kilojoules. Then this WHE will be 1363.46 kilojoules. So WHE is also calculated. Now we can find out Q2 with the help of this Q1 and WHE. For that, I will do energy balance at this heat engine. At this heat engine, I will do energy balance. That means summation of energy entering this heat engine is equal to summation of energy leaving the heat engine. So summation of energy entering, there is only one energy entering, that is Q1. So energy balance, that will be Q1 is equal to Q2 is coming out plus W heat engine. So to find out Q2, this will be Q1 minus WHE. So this will be Q1. It is 1900 minus WHE is 1363.46. So this Q2 is 536.53 kilojoules. So we have calculated W heat engine and heat rejected to the sink, that is also calculated. Now when we come to this refrigerator part, here there is a term, that is net work output from the combined heat engine and refrigerator plant is 290 kilojoules. So actually the heat that is the work that is produced by heat engine is not completely used by refrigerator. Some work is used for other purposes in this case. So if we do energy balance at this point, if we do energy balance, this will be WHE equal to W net plus W refrigerator. So sum of all energy entering is equal to sum of all energy leaving. So here energy entering is in the form of work that is produced by heat engine, that is equal to net work output plus that work that is used for a refrigerator. So here WHE is known. WHE is 1363.46 equal to W net is 290 kilojoules plus W refrigerator. So W refrigerator is 1073.46 kilojoules. So this is the work that is consumed by this refrigerator. So this is a reversible refrigerator. We can find out COP of this reversible refrigerator. From that we can find out Q2 dash. After calculating Q2 dash, from that we can calculate Q1 dash. So our objective in this problem is to find out this Q2 dash and summation of Q2 and Q1 dash. So for that I will have COP of this reversible refrigerator. So COP of reversible refrigerator is desired effect divided by work input. Here desired effect is this T2 dash. So this is T2 dash divided by T1 dash minus T2 dash. Here it is known T2 dash is 258 Kelvin. It is 258 divided by 303 minus 258. 303 is T1 dash. Actually that is equal to T2. Both the reservoirs are common here. So it is 303 minus 258. So that will be 5.73. So the COP of this reversible refrigerator is 5.73, and this COP is actually given by this formula. COP is desired effect divided by work input once again. So desired effect here it is Q2 dash divided by work input is W refrigerator I'm taking. So it is 5.73 equal to Q2 dash divided by this refrigerator work input that refrigerator that value is 1073.46. So then this Q2 dash will be 6150.92 kilojoules. This is Q2 dash. The first calculation, that is Q2 dash, is calculated now. This is what exactly the heat that is received by the refrigerant in the refrigerator, that is Q2 dash. To find out Q2 plus Q1 dash, from this we can find out Q1 dash. So for that, let's have energy balance at this refrigerator. So that is summation of all energy entering is equal to summation of all energy leaving this refrigerator. So summation of all energy entering will be like this. That is Q2 dash plus W, that is into refrigerator, that is equal to Q1 dash. So Q2 dash is 6150.92 plus work input to refrigerator will be this 1073.46. 1073.46, that is equal to Q1 dash. So Q1 dash equal to 7224.38 kilojoules. This is Q1 dash. Then we should find out Q1 dash plus Q2. So Q1 dash, it is 7224.38 plus Q2, it is calculated here, it is 536.53. So this total will be 7760.91 kilojoules. So now let us come to this one. Here Q2 dash is this one, 6150.92 kilojoules. It is 6150.92 kilojoules, that is Q2 dash. Then that Q2 plus Q1 dash will be 7760.91. So that is calculated. Thank you.